Talk a little bit about toxins. You know, that's, I think, an area where people can get overwhelmed trying to reduce them or to reduce their exposure, since we're around them every day. How important is that to either detox or try to reduce what, you know, goes right in and on and around your body?
Yeah, well, toxins are ubiquitous, okay? Literally ubiquitous. So they're everywhere, and they're in everything you do. You know, from the time you wake up, well, first of all, just examine in your bed what kind of mattress you have, what kind of linens do you have, what is your air quality like. Then you wake up and you take a shower, your shower water is loaded with chemicals unless you have a shower filter, and then men put half the amount of potions that a girl does unless you're metrosexual, and then you might use much more potions and lotions and perfumes. but we have to stop the introduction. And fortunately, in this day and time, there's a plethora of natural things. So like everything that I put on my body is all 100% natural. There's no chemicals, there's no toxins of anything. Even how I wash my clothes, my linens, I buy organic linens. You're not gonna get away from everything.
Right.
So the solution is, how do we purify ourselves every day? Because we're all in the same boat. Okay, your living environment is no different than mine. Maybe though, if you paint cars every day, your living environment is way worse than someone who doesn't have that kind of hazardous job. Or let's say you work in a chemical factory where they're using lots of chemicals. Or like, let's say you're a hairdresser where there's, oh my goodness, thousands of chemicals as a hairdresser. And I know, because I tell my hairdresser patients, okay, look, you need to create a living sanctuary that's purified. But anyway, so you have to, like, you're not gonna get away. And probably the most significant toxin we have today is the invisible energy web that we have around us, with all the Wi-Fi and the computers and the 5G and all the things that are happening. And I would say that's probably our most significant influencer today. And so you've got to connect with nature every day. You've got to go and, you know, be connected to the earth. You need to be connected to a tree. You need to be connected with the ocean, something like that, because it's just, unfortunately, what we have to do in order to balance those negative energies of, and we're, you know, we're not going to get away from it.
Right.
There's cell towers, there're connections all over. I mean, it's abominable, and I don't care, even if you try to protect your house, but what about all the neighbors around you, and what about the cell towers? So, and everything goes through a cinder block. Everything transmits through all kinds of materials. So unfortunately, you're going to have to learn how to, one, you know, not sleep with your cell phone, not be around the computer. I turn off the electricity to my bedroom every night. Personally, I juice 10 ounces of green juice every day. I do buy all organic, pretty much, you know, not always, but I would say most of the time. Sometimes I go out to eat, so I don't know how great it is. But I do things to purify myself every day. I take liver support every day. I do a liver cleanse. I have an infrared sauna. So I do things, but it's not, really isn't that complicated. I tell people, don't try to reinvent everything today. Make one little accomplishment every day. I didn't get rid of all my plastics all at once. I slowly got rid of all the plastics, replaced it with glass or ceramic. And so you do it slowly, but surely you do it. But unfortunately, purification is not optional anymore. Not today. If you just go out and sit in any corner, it's, people are not healthy. And we all have to take a stand and encourage one another. Not point out everybody's faults and their wrongdoings and everything, but how can we be lovers and encouragers with one another?